Attention, cadets. This is your captain speaking. I would like to wish you all a safe flight back to your respective planets for a short, hard-earned holiday. Please be sure to give your respect to departing chiefs Ibbotson, Harmon, and Abernathy on your way to the departure bays. See you in 2 weeks. Most of you, at least.
Happy Heim's Day. Written by Boudica Eads and Nolan Eddisford Finlay, whoever they are.
Can't let my last quarter as chief go to waste, can I? I need to make an impression.
And you needed the dead bodies of about a million trees for that?
Gross. It's paperwork.
I can see that.
I'm gonna do something amazing, something remarkable, something the Reaver has never seen.
Central heating?
Look at you, haha, real comedian. No. I'm going to have a party.
I hate to break it to you, Kay, but the Reaver's seen parties before. Quite a lot of them, actually.
Aha! But that's where you're wrong, my cybernetic computerized chum. This will be a party like no other.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we can all dress up, and I'll decorate the hall with lights and plants and make it look like some kind of forest and...
Ah, so you mean a Liu party?
What?
Just saying. It sounds exactly like Sky's party last year.
Seriously? Can't I just do one unique thing?
Nothing is unique. Everything has been done before. Nihil sub sol novum.
Thank you for your comments, oh wise one.
Anytime.
What if I put snow on the trees? Sky didn't do that.
Kay, I think you're missing the...
I could put up some of those super trees. The all-year trees. The evergreens. Yes. Snowy evergreens. And those little red berry things. They're around for the fourth quarter, right? Oh, my God. Okay, we could do some of those fake mises? No. That's not... Okay, team, I am planning the best party the ship has ever seen, and you, Unit 42, are my committee.
I have a question.
Yes, AJ, go ahead.
Why?
Why?
Why are we doing this? What's the point?
Does there need to be a point? Party's a party!
To celebrate my time as Year 2 Chief, the end of the year is always so sad, and I thought as my last enactment I might try to cheer everyone up with a goodbye party. Anyone else?
It's not that big of an achievement.
Yes, Lane.
I think it's a good idea.
You would, wouldn't you?
Yeah, well...
So do we have a theme?
A theme?
Yeah, I'm thinking winter, like... proper winter back home. Snow and trees and...
We've already done that.
No, it's different. It's gonna be different. More warm. Less sharp.
Sorry, are we still talking about parties?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, well, let me know when and where it is, and I'll be there. A party's a party, isn't it?
Okay, so can I organize the decor? Do we want invitations? I can make invitations. Is there a dress code?
Can the captain come?
I can do all that. It's my party.
Okay. Don't you want any help? I know how stressed
no,
you can...
No, no, I'll be fine. Thanks. I like doing things by myself.
If you say so.
Right. Meeting adjourned.
What was the point of that if she isn't gonna let anyone do anything?
Maybe she wants emotional support.
Shh. Sorry. Nothing new, eh? Reva?
How can I help you?
FX4YJ.
Do you have any records of winter-themed parties?
I am not able to grant your request right now. Are you perhaps looking for Republic Day, year-round preparations?
Oh, come on, Reva. You can bend the rules for a buddy, can't you? Don't you want to help me?
Affirmative.
Thank you.
Jacob, there you are. I swear I've looked all over for you.
Shh, sorry.
But seriously, I looked everywhere. I never thought you'd be in the library. Why are you here?
Can't a man improve his mind?
You literally can't. Or have you forgotten that you have access to every piece of information ever in existence?
But do I?
Yes. That's what you always say.
Well, I have some news for you. Because yours truly has just uncovered something new. Or technically very, very old.
Dare I ask?
It's actually super cool. I found records of this ritual, a magical one, I think, performed by the people who used to occupy Earth, before the Republic. The details are blurry, but the festivities surrounding the ritual, they sound a lot like your party.
That can't be true. The Republic has been on Earth for forever. It's probably just fairy stories, folklore.
Okay. Maybe it is. But there is one idea you might like.
Yeah?
Well, part of the whole ritual thing, real or not, was present giving.
Like birthday presents?
Yeah, except it's a secret. Like, everyone gets one for someone else, but you don't know who got who what.
Huh?
I just thought if you wanted to do something different...
Oh, Jacob! You beautiful man!
This is new.
Thank you. I knew you'd come around to this idea. And honestly, thank God, I could not organize this thing without you. It's already so stressful.
Exactly how much are you letting other people do?
I just need some emotional support, okay? Otherwise, I can do this. I'm chief, damn it.
Uh-huh. Or maybe you just...
I do like that present idea, though. Yeah, I'm gonna steal that. Don't you dare say anything.
Oh, no. I was planning on turning you over to the authorities for theft of folklore.
Ha. Ha. Okay, so I split all the years into groups with their unit, and they're all going to pick names for the present thingy today. I've made a list of decorations and of people invited, which is everyone. I need to find some ribbon for all the presents so they look the same, though, and maybe some paper. Obviously, this is all just planning, and we haven't even really started yet, but we still need the captain's permission.
Kay!
Oh, here we go.
Yeah?
Please, I'm begging you to let me help. You've never planned anything like this before, and I'm not saying that you'll do a bad job, but seriously, I have so many ideas.
That's a nice offer, but I'm fine. Really.
No, you're not. All you've done is carry that pile of paperwork around and look stressed. All week.
Sky might actually have a point.
Thank you.
So what? I'm still in the planning stages.
And the party's in what, 3 days?
Please, 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 I'm begging you.
Harmon?
Fine, fine. You can help. But only if you do exactly what I say. Here, you can get ribbons. Teal ones. Fine. And you can get these plants from the greenhouse. I'm sure Lane will know where to find them. Okay, okay. Do you have a hat?
A hat?
Yes, a hat. Okay, everyone, here's the gist. Pick one name out of the hat.
What?
If you get your name, put it back. This is not the time for self-love. Hat is courtesy of Sky. Thank you, Sky, for the hat. If you can't read the name, go ask Sky about it. Unless it says Sky. Then come talk to me about it.
But if,
If it says K, then talk to me, obviously.
No, I meant...
Shut up, AJ!
Your name's...
AJ!
All right!
Go on. Someone.
I'll go first.
Thank you.
Who'd you get?
I'm not telling you. Here you go, sir. Your turn.
I can't believe you roped me into this ridiculous...
It's a bit of fun. Here.
Well, that didn't give much away.
FX4YJ?
Yes, sir.
Your turn?
AJ?
Very nice. Who's next?
Enter. Ah, Officer Zai.
Arnold?
Can I do something for you?
Have you heard of the party? The party.
I try my best to turn a blind eye to the cadets' extracurricular activities, officer. And I suggest you do the same for fear of a massive headache. Now, if that's all, I've got some important paperwork to deal with. Why are you still here?
This is more than innocent fun, Captain. It's practically a Himes Day celebration, wouldn't you say?
I beg your pardon?
You see now the issue. How dangerous it could be if news of this party, however innocent its intentions, were to reach the wrong ears. I'm not sure the council would look kindly upon one of its captains instigating such a celebration.
But I haven't.
And the council would believe you? I'm sure Alar's father would have a lot to say about his son's participation in an unconstitutional, traitorous event. And you, of all people, should know how that family can twist things.
Right, yes. Thank you, officer, for informing me of the, situation.
My pleasure.
However, I do question why someone of your rank knows anything about Heimsday? And how exactly do you believe word of this party will spread? Unless you're suggesting that someone on this ship will tell the council about a student party, which would be, well, ridiculous, wouldn't it?
But...
let the kids have some fun, huh? Maybe even have some fun yourself.
Hey, Lane.
Sky.
How's Reggie?
Oh, he's good, aren't you, buddy?
Huh, cute. I'm here for some plants.
Plants? What kind of plants?
Pine branches, the red berry spiky ones.
Holly?
I don't know. This is ridiculous. She asked me to help with a stupid party ball thing, and all she has me doing is picking up some stupid plants and writing some stupid names on some stupid bits of paper going into some stupid hat. And all that after days worth of nagging.
I thought it was a rather nice hat.
Not the point.
Sorry. Look, maybe she just didn't want you to feel left out. Huh?
So she gives me useless jobs and makes me feel like I'm getting in the way instead? Yeah, lovely.
She's not intentionally.
I know that. I'm not stupid, but it's just so infuriating. She obviously needs my help, but she'd rather run about losing her hair over everything because she can't bear the idea of me mucking up her perfect little plans. All because I picked up turquoise ribbons instead of teal. Like, honestly, Kay, it's not the end of the world.
Maybe
she's just too much of a control freak for her own good. Huh? You consider that?
Sky.
I'm sorry. She's just... she's really bugging me. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry. That was mean. Oh, come here. I can't handle your little sad, sappy face.
Look, you just need to talk to her about it. Say everything you said to me, just maybe a bit nicer.
Ah, but I can't talk to her about it. She'll just snap at me.
You don't know that.
Oh, I do.
You don't know until you've tried.
With Kay? I don't need to try.
Well, I guess I could talk to her about it.
Oh, would you? That'd be fantastic. Oh, thank you, Lane. You're the best. Maybe you could do it while we're dropping off the plants?
Oh, right, yeah. What do you need again?
As many fourth quarter cold weather plants as you can bring, and some fake snow. If you can do that, that'd be amazing.
Yeah, on it.
Amazing. You're the greatest. Aren't you the greatest? Yes, you are. Appreciate everything. Thanks for the talk.
No problemo.
Hey, Jacob, wait up.
Who are you to command me?
Can't you, like, sense if someone is literally running up behind you?
Yes.
So why didn't you... whatever. I need your help.
My help? All right. What can I do for you?
It's Ingrid, right?
Mm-hmm.
I pulled Ingrid for the present thingy.
Funny. I seem to remember the main point of that being secrecy.
Yes, I know, but I really, really need your help. I don't know what to get her.
You don't know what to get her?
No.
No?
No.
Oh. How sad. I'm sure you'll figure it out something, buddy. She is your girlfriend, after all.
I swear I've thought of everything. Maybe makeup, but no, she might get the wrong idea. Maybe clothes, but no, she might get the wrong idea. Maybe plants, but what if she can't keep it alive? Maybe flowers? That's pretty soppy, right? Isn't it? Chocolate would melt. Pretty lousy gift anyway. I've considered guns. She already has those. Swords? She doesn't know how to use them. Please, Jacob, I wouldn't ask otherwise.
I'll take pity on you, because clearly you're going to need all the help you can get.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Don't thank me yet.
Right.
If I know Ingrid, which I do, she doesn't mind what you get her.
But...
honestly, as long as it shows that you know her, she doesn't give a toss. It can be something small, practical... something she'll use in her everyday life. She'll appreciate a big extravagance. Of course she will. It's Ingrid. She's the human embodiment of it. But to her, deep down, like the rest of us, it's the little things that count. The effort that went into them. That makes sense?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Plus, she already knows you're rich.
Right, right. So I should make something?
You could.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I'll make something. Thanks, Jacob.
Oh, no. This is all wrong.
Babe, it's okay. Calm down.
Okay? This is not okay. Those trees are tiny. Tiny. And they aren't even going in the right place. Who is this party for? Tiny people? Children? No. It is a sophisticated ending to my year as chief, and it's all going wrong.
Maybe you need to take a step back and let someone else take charge, huh?
Don't be ridiculous.
I mean, it's pretty much done. I could step in if you like.
No, I'm not going to make you organize my party for me. That would be mean.
You wouldn't be making me do anything. Look, I know maybe I'm not the best person to set up a party, but Skye's really good at that. And she's free, and she wants to...
help? No, she doesn't. All she wants to do is take credit. Just like she did when I got chief, and she was all like, oh, you wouldn't have gotten it if it weren't for me. And oh, we're basically chief together.
Maybe she feels left out.
Skye? Left out? Please.
I'm serious. Have you considered that this might be an end of an era for her as well?
No. What do you think you're doing? That tree is practically in the fireplace. How are we going to light a big, cozy fire when there's a tree in there? Don't just shrug. Look, move out of the way. I'll do it.
Okay, just... Kay! Oh my god, Kay!
Are you okay? Are you hurt?
Oh, what do you think?
Why don't we take you to the medbay, huh?
No. I have things to do.
No, you don't.
Yes. Yes, I do.
Kay, I love you, you're an idiot, and I'm gonna give you two choices. You go to the medbay and rest, or you go to your room and rest.
But what about...
It'll be fine. I have it under control.
Kay.
Fine. But I'm not going to the med bay.
Aha. So I win.
Yeah. You win. Thank you.
No problem. Right, people, move your asses. Where is she? It's her party.
Relax, she'll be here.
I went to all this effort helping her out with this, and for what? So she could show up late?
Funny, I don't recall...
Maybe she stood you up.
Really?
Yeah, maybe she...
Hi.
Hi. You look...
What took you so long?
Making myself presentable.
You are more than presentable. You're stunning.
You don't look too bad yourself.
Save me the romantics.
I got your present?
The whole thing is meant to be secret.
Not for the gift exchange.
Oh.
Just for you. Congratulations. Well done for being the most beautiful chief the Reaver's ever seen.
I didn't get you anything.
That's okay. Open it now.
Okay. It's my badge.
Not exactly.
It's definitely my badge.
Oh, this is going to sound silly now. I know that you love being chief more than anything, and I know that despite this whole party, you're not ready to give it up and give up that badge. I know it's tradition, right, to pass the badge on to the next generation, so I thought maybe if you had your own, like, really your own badge, that...
It's perfect. Thank you. You're perfect.
Hey.
Hey, babe. I know it's supposed to be, like, secret or whatever, but I just thought, you know, it'll come out eventually, so... And it's today, anyway, and... whatever. Just take it.
Okay. Oh! Oh! Wow!
Yeah. Go on, and open it.
Hey, that's a bit...
Just ignore that.
Right? Oh, my... I love it. Thank you, AJ.
There's, mittens, too. I attached them with a string so you wouldn't lose them.
Very thoughtful.
Yeah, thanks. They've got cat ears, too.
Oh, cute.
They're kitten mittens.
Kitten mittens.
Kitten mittens.
Very clever. I didn't realize you could knit.
Oh, yeah, just recently... Ran out of other skills to be good at.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Plus, I needed, covers for my, guns. Pew pew. I'll get you another drink.
Okay.
I.
That was brilliant.
Oh, come off it. He was trying to be sweet.
And remind me whose hands spontaneously combust. It would be a shame for them to experience a fire-related death.
Oh, come on. They're cute.
Pull it together, AJ. You're an ally, for goodness sake. Act like it. Goddamn.
This is not what your mother and I expected.
Oh. Sorry. Didn't see you there.
No problem. Got something wrong with your uniform?
No.
Then stop fiddling with it. You look like an idiot. Just saying.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, actually.
Well... Maybe you should get better at aiming for the glass when you pour yourself a drink. Makes you look a bit like an idiot.
What? Oh, shit!
Just saying.
I... Motherfucker!
Can't I just open whatever unfortunate thing I've been given in private? Save everyone the embarrassment.
Nope.
Is that any way to...
No, sir. Come on, we never get to do anything together. Anything that isn't...
Lane, I've got an important mission for you. It's really boring and horrible mission, and I can't be bothered to explain it properly, but I'm sure you've got it. You're just like your mother that way.
Oh, look, we've arrived.
So we have, Lane. So we have. Hi.
Hi.
What's wrong?
Oh, come on.
I don't see why. I've already given you your present, and...
Has everyone already gotten their presents?
Yeah. No?
Seriously? It was meant to be a secret. That's half the fun.
Oh, boo-hoo. Presents are presents. Who cares if it's a secret?
Who cares? Are you kidding me? I care, Ingrid. I care. That was the whole point. Fine. That's fine. It's whatever. Who hasn't gotten their present yet? Raised hands.
You're joking.
Huh. Who would have guessed? That just leaves...
Well, it's hardly a secret anymore.
Just open it. Sir.
Why, thank you, whichever one of you got this for me. It will be very useful for all the paperwork I have to fill out.
Click it.
Okay.
Best captain ever.
This is... a relief. Thought you'd gone soft on me there, King.
What am I even doing here? This is Investigator Barnett. It's my day off, and I don't even know what I'm doing here. The case has just infected me. I feel as if I could reach out and they would be right there. Like I could touch them. Kay, Sky, Lane, Jacob, Ingrid. It's also fascinating. Of course, we never celebrated anything this way. That would be unheard of in my family. I mean, even birthdays were barely acknowledged. Pat on the back and a well done for getting older. I know the other kids are getting cake, but we thought you should prepare yourself for the real world. I'm getting off track here. The point is, this shows a dedication to... Well, they were all still loyal to the state, as far as I can tell, but... God. What's the point of it? Why bother at all? Putting this all together clearly left a strain on Harmon and Lou. Haller really stuck his worth in trying to do something for Vega that ended up failing miserably. Is it all worth it? For one night, just to what? Stick in these kids' minds for the rest of time? Is this the first sign of some possible selfish reason for revolt? To get your name forever engraved in the history books? No. Harmon wouldn't give it all for that. She was chief, for Pete's sake. She was celebrating that. It was so important to her. Was for so long. I mean, just look at... Oh, Ezra, you idiot. This has nothing to do with the case. This audio was important, they'd have gave it off the bat. You've gained no insight, just sat around listening to a bunch of teenagers fuck around. As if that wasn't bad enough, you've wasted your day off. Some investigator I am. Some investigator, eh? Mother would be shocked. Looks like I finally did it. Something shocking. Little old Ezra, straight lace, tip-top, goody-two-shoe, baby buddy Ezra. Too bad it's also pathetic. This is Investigator Ezra Barnett, signing off after after a deeply disappointing day.
This is Investigator Ezra Barnett with exclusive outside of work hour footage of him doing this beautiful job and telling you my beautiful realizations. So I left you on a bummer, big bummer, the biggest bummer, in fact, and I believe that I was false in that action. See, I've been thinking a lot. I found some, Prosecco or something. I think it's mine, just found it down there, you know. It's the day off, why not? And I drank a bit of that and thought about stuff, and I realized something very, very important. I may know nothing more about our nearest and dearest year three cadets, but I have weeks of that, and I have all the time in the world if I so want it, so screw them. Today, I learned something about myself. How am I, as a person, as an investigator, supposed to understand other people if I don't understand myself, huh? Know thyself and know your enemy and all that, and I definitely know more about myself now than I did, at least more than I did 24 hours ago. I think that's beautiful. Do I condone breaking and entering into your workplace on your day off? No, absolutely not. Do I condone being proactive and using mandatory rest to really better yourself as a single cog in the brilliant machine that is our wonderful republic? Of course, any day. And that's all I'm doing here, really, if you think about it. And I am thinking quite a lot. Oh, that's my waffle. Oh, potato waffles. Truly humanity's greatest creation. Cheers. Long live our republic.
Hi, Mom. I know, I shouldn't be sending this. It's stupid and dangerous, but I miss you. A lot. And I'm in a place without surveillance, on a secure, non-sentient device. And after I'm done recording, I'll send this to you on an even secure channel, so really there's nothing to worry about. It's Himes Day today. You probably know that, alright. Can't believe I almost forgot. It got me thinking about you. About the others. About what we'd be doing around now, back home. Warming up by the fire, telling stories, eating some good, proper food. Ugh, my. I'd kill for some of your food up here. Space food is the worst. But I digress. They don't celebrate it here, obviously. Or, at least, I thought they didn't. But one of the other cadets had a whole party, and they even did a present swapping, so I'm not sure what to make of that. Oh! I had another brush with death. Or, not death. A boy. He saw me fiddling with my uniform, but, well, he seemed rude and mostly uninterested, so I think I haven't blown it. Oh, I really hope I haven't blown it. I promise, Mom. I'll make you proud. I'll change the world, I'm sure I will. I can feel it in my bones. Something about this ship, the people I've met so far. Hope is a dangerous thing, I know that. But I can feel it. I'm going to, I'm sure of it. I'm going to change the world, or I'll die trying.
This episode featured, in order of appearance, Mark Trafell as Captain Arnold Abernathy, Jack Fairweather as Jacob Fields, Willow Smith as Kay Harmon, Chris Rogers as AJ Allar, Emily Burtwhittle as Ingrid Vega, Johnny Scarson as Kai Liu, Leda Byatt as Lane King, Mads Franken as the Reaver, Devon Bohr as Officer Zai, Cecil Sykes as Ren Scott, and Akiva Vita as Investigator Ezra Barnett. Produced and directed by Boudicca Eads, with sound design by Nolan Edisford Finley.